Welcome. In this video, we are going to create this Dalmatian spots pattern in SVG. The pattern is relatively simple, random black spots on white. We will implement this the procedural way, enabling ourselves to easily create millions of variations in the end. Let's get into it. I will be using this layer for development. The left side is the coding area, and the right side is the SVG preview. First off, let's add the SVG tag with the mandatory XML namespace. Then let's add a rectangle that fills the whole SVG, so we set its width and height to 100%. We will use this rect as a canvas on which we can paint with filter effects. So as our next step, we are going to add a filter and apply it on the rectangle. With this foundation, anything we do with the filter will be rendered on the full viewport. The only source of randomness in SVG is through the turbulence filter effect, which generates Perlin noise. So we're gonna add a feTurbulence element, which will have an output that we can transform into random spots. We need to set a positive value as base frequency to have it generate noise. Let's do 0.01. I find this value to be quite manageable and a good start. What we have now looks like a colorful mess, but it is actually four noise layers blended together. A unique noise pattern is generated on each color channel and the alpha channel as well. However, only the alpha noise can be considered pure, because the color channels don't affect it. On the other hand, the color channels have a little imprint of the alpha in them, namely where alpha is zero, the color value becomes zero as well. For this reason, we're going to make use of only the alpha noise in the following. One way to visualize the variance of opacity is to render it as grayscale, where transparent is black, opaque is white, and everything in between is some shade of gray. We're going to achieve this with the help of the color matrix filter effect. FE color matrix applies a matrix transformation on each pixel of the input to create an output. The matrix describes how the R, G, B, and A components of the new pixel are calculated based on the components of the input pixel and an optional constant. It functions in the linearized RGB color space, where the intensity is described by float values between 0 and 1 inclusive. Our case is not too complex. We have to make sure that the output R, G, and B components equal the input A component. The values of the fourth column are the multipliers of the alpha input, and the first three rows control the R, G, and B components on the output. We are gonna put once in these places to turn alpha into grayscale. The fourth row is about calculating the output alpha. With all zeros, our output is fully transparent. That's why we don't see any noise yet. The last column is for the constant offset. We need to put 1 here to make our output opaque, that is, visible. Let's take a look at our image now. We see some dark lines and some brighter areas between them. What if we isolated these areas that look a bit like spots? One way to isolate the brightest parts is to make them white and clear the rest by making them black. Essentially, we have to set a threshold above which everything is turned white, and below it everything is turned black. The component transfer filter effect allows a finer grain of control over transforming color values per pixel. A custom function can be defined for each component. Let's add this filter effect. By default, each component uses the identity function, which means the image is untouched. To define a transfer function, we have to add a child for the corresponding component. In case of red, this is fe func r. Now we need to set the type of the function. The best fit for our case is the discrete type, which defines a step transfer function. The steps are defined through the table values attribute, where we set the height of each step by space-separated numbers. The width of the steps are always the range divided by the number of steps. So if we define two steps, then each of them will cover half of the range. In case of three steps, a step will have the width of the third of the range, and so on. Let's start simple by setting two steps, 0 and 1. Our image has a dominant bluish tint now. Furthermore, some whitish spots appeared. We only defined a transfer function for the red channel, and it seems we eliminated most red from the image with it. The remaining blue and green components produce the aqua-like hue, while the spots are a bit reddish because the red component is at maximum on those parts. We could add the same transfer function for the green and blue components to make the image black and white. However, then we would need to keep three elements in sync, which is better to be avoided. An alternative approach is to move the FE component transfer before the color matrix and solely define the alpha transfer function. The color matrix only routes the alpha values to the RGB channels, so it doesn't matter whether the transformation is applied on its input or output. Note that we used fefunc_a for defining the transfer function for the alpha component. Now we have some white spots on black, with a transfer function that turns alpha values below 0.5 to 0, and turns alpha values of 0.5 and above to 1. Let's invert the steps so we will have black spots on white. We are getting closer to our goal, but at this state I think the result is barely passable as Dalmatian spots. Fortunately, we can adjust some parameters to produce a better result. First, let's change the base frequency so we can see a little more of the pattern. If we double its value, the spots become smaller, but at the same time, we see more of them. Notice how this change didn't alter the density of the spots though, which I think is too low currently. Another adjustment we could do is changing the step function. For example, if we added another zero step, the size and number of the spots should increase. Let's do that. Now the density increased, but the shape of the spots became stranger. Even though there are three steps defined currently, the function can be viewed as a two-step function. The threshold is at about 0.33, below which everything is converted to 1, resulting white, and everything above 0.33 is converted to 0, resulting black. As we practically increased the width of the zero step, new spots appeared, older ones grew, and some of them merged with others. On the other hand, we have some areas that are notably empty. One way to even out these inconsistencies is to add octaves to the noise. feTurbulence has an optional attribute called numOctaves for setting the number of octaves rendered. By default, its value is 1, but let's see what happens if we double it. It truly added some more spots to the image, but many of them are having quite an unusual outline. We can change the noise type on feTurbulence to fractal noise and see if it is a better fit. The fractal noise type is more balanced in terms of low and high values. Right now we see some white spots, these are the low values. However, we need black spots, so inverting the steps makes sense. And we could also make the high values spots, so let's turn the third step 0. Now the spot distribution is roughly even, and while the shapes aren't always round, I think we have good similarity to the Dalmatian's coat. One last thing we could do is to change the base frequency to a lower value to kind of zoom into the pattern. When I created it, I went with 0.006. Having a Dalmatian pattern is great, but each dog has a unique coat. And what if you want to portray 101 Dalmatians? They can't have literally the same markings. Luckily, we have a simple method for varying the pattern. If we set the seed attribute on feTurbulence to a positive integer other than 1, it will produce a new variation. You can use a random number up to 16 million and generate a unique variation. If we remove this attribute, the default seed value will be used, which is 1. Lastly, you might want to keep the size of the file as small as possible, especially if you want to create multiple variants. SVGO is a Node.js tool that can help us with that. I already have it installed on my machine, and I'm going to use the command line version of it. I can simply pass the file to SVGO as the first argument, and it will minify the code. The size of the optimized version is 346 bytes, which is quite small compared to what visual we can produce with it. So this is it. We've just learned how to create a Dalmatian spots pattern that fits in about a third of a kilobyte. You can check out the code following the CodePen link in the description. Thanks for watching, and see you next time!